Kenyan President Uhuru Kenyatta could face an impeachment motion over the teachers' pay dispute. The opposition Coalition for Reforms and Democracy says it will institute impeachment proceedings against the president for violating the constitution which he swore to uphold and defend. COD says the government's refusal to honor a court order awarding teachers a pay of 50% to 60% rise is a violation of the country's supreme law. Rita Tinina has that story.
The third week into the teachers' strike and the parties in the teachers' pay dispute are still maintaining their hardline stance. Teachers insisting they will not go back to class until the government effects their 50% to 60% pay rise ordered by the courts. The government, on the other hand, has maintained it cannot afford to pay and won't pay the teachers. President Uhuru Kenyatta last week rolled out any pay increase for teachers, and that has gotten him into fresh trouble with the opposition.
Violating court orders and refusal to obey court orders is a serious violation of the constitution, more so coming from the head of state.
The opposition's criticism of the president and the government is nothing new, but on the teachers' pay dispute, COD is speaking on a new battlefront.
We as a coalition have instructed our team in the National Assembly, led by our leadership there, including party leaders who are represented there, to immediately start instituting impeachment proceedings against the President of the Republic of Kenya for violating the Constitution of the Republic that he swore to protect, to defend, and to uphold under whatever circumstances.
The impeachment plot will be driven by Suba MP John Mbadi. COD will not give any details on when the impeachment motion will be tabled before the House.
You wait and see.
The coalition, however, says it has begun lobbying members of the National Assembly.
They took an oath to defend, protect and uphold the Constitution. And we are going to call upon them to rise to the occasion and give meaning to that oath they took.
COD insists the government can afford to pay and should pay teachers.
It is, to many of us, not a substantial sum of money, given that the sum total of the increment only amounts to 1.3 billion per month, aggregating an average of about 17 to 18 billion per annum.
The coalition will next Wednesday hold a demonstration which will culminate in a rally in Nairobi to show solidarity with the teachers. The Kenya Union of Post-Primary Education Teachers, KUPET, has written to the Speaker and Clerk of the National Assembly, as well as the majority and minority leaders, seeking to have the House reconvene over the crisis in the education sector.
And address an issue of immediate concern that has occurred, and can go ahead and allocate money to pay teachers their 50-60%.
The courts will on Friday next week make a ruling on whether or not the teachers' strike is protected under the law. Rita Tinina, KTN News.